Let us understand the basics of MVC. Before proceeding on our study of MVC, let us try to understand how it is different from the traditional web programming technologies. We'll start it right now. This is the address bar. You type something here, www.hoven.in/index.htm. In traditional programming, this address bar maps to a file on the server. When this command is sent to the server, it reaches that IP address and picks this file. It reads the contents of the file and transmits them to your browser, which interprets the HTML and presents a picture to you, some tables, some grids, some flash. This is produced by interpreting the HTML that is coming from this file. If it is an ASP.NET website, then the same thing written on the address bar again maps to a web page. It is a different thing that this page requires a processing and then it sends the HTML. But at the end of the day, this line maps to a file. It's a different thing that a plain HTML file comes without processing and this ASPX file comes after processing. Now in MVC, this story is very different. This is how it looks like. You are typing on the address bar a URL like this. If it had been plain ASP.NET, then XYZ would have been some folder, PQR would have been some folder, and inside it some default file might have been there. But in case of MVC, this URL contains the name of a class, and the name of a public function inside it. It could be that XYZ is a ready-made, is a class inside your program, and PQR is a function inside this class. There is no folder by the name XYZ. There is no folder by the name PQR. The URL looks the same. People type it as usual. But it contains a hidden information about